Hey guys, so today I'm going to be coiling this hair after braiding it. So I've been asked this question a couple of times, if you can actually coil the hair after braiding it instead of just recoiling, and today I'm going to be showing you just that. So as you can see, this is a stretch. I stretched this hair already. It's a color 30 braided hair, and now I'm just going to be braiding this, and after braiding it I'm going to coil the hair, and I'm just going to show you how I did just that. So this beautiful hair right here, she doesn't want gel on her hair because for some weird reasons it tends to cut her hair because her hair is very smooth. I don't know if anyone like experienced that, like having gel on your hair, at the end of the day your hair is like cutting and it's so fragile and stuff. So but definitely guys, I'm going to be showing you other alternative you can actually do, because at the end of the day you might be having some flyaways if you're not really an expert in braiding the hair, and I'm just going to show you how you can actually manage to make the hair without actually putting on gel, and the hair is going to lay perfectly. So for this method, I really find it very easy to do because first of all, like, it gives a uniform coil, and secondly it doesn't even waste time at all. Like, you can do this in seconds and it is going to come out very beautiful. And just when you get to the tips of the hair, you are going to be leaving some hair, so I'm going to show you how you tie it down and then you're going to leave some hair. So guys, I really don't want to waste much of your time. I just want to go straight to the point, but at least I still want to do it so you have an idea what I am doing. So like I said guys, I didn't add gel to the hair, but I'm definitely going to be giving you an alternative. So as you can see, the hair is properly laid. There are no flyovers, like the hair is like really beautiful. So right now I'm just going to start, and I'm just adding like a normal hair oil, like a soulmate hair cream to the hair. So what I did guys, I just added water. So all you have to do is just to like add water to your hand and then you're going to lay it. So this is going to lay properly and you are not going to have flyovers. These, as you can see, like everything is so nice and easy. So it is a knotless braid I'm doing. I'm just like braiding it. So when I get to a point where the hair is like slim or tender, all I'm going to do is just to add some hair, and as you can see everything is concealed, it doesn't even show at all. So this is like a tiny braid I'm doing. I literally took just 6 hours in doing this hair because of the length is really long guys, so it took me some time to do. So by the time I'm done guys, this is what we have. The hair is looking so beautiful. So just when you get to the tips, just like you saw in the video, you are just going to tie the tips of the hair, and then that is just it. So you can tie it anywhere you want to. So right now I'm going to be putting the hair in hot water, definitely after you finish trimming the fly away from the braided hair. So just like you would when you finish braiding your hair, I'm going to be putting it in hot water, but this is slightly different because I added a conditioner and I added oil to the hair. So I'm going to be showing you the oil and the conditioner pretty soon. So after putting it in hot water, this is what it should look like. So right now I'm just going to comb this guys. If you have like a straighter pattern, it is okay. If you have this, it is still fine. Either ways, once you're coiling the hair, it is definitely going to like uniform. So right now I'm going to be going over with a flexible rod. So I'm using a big size flexible rod. I don't know if this is the biggest size in the market, but this is definitely not the small size. So that is what I'll be using to coil up this hair, just the tips of the hair. So guys, just in case you want to ask if you can flat iron the hair instead of putting it in hot water before, I don't recommend that, because you know, if you finish braiding your hair normally, you're supposed to put it in hot water so all the flyaway can actually lay down from the roots down to the tips. But once you've coiled this hair, all you're going to be focusing on is just the tips. Just the tips of the hair is what you focus on when you finish rolling the hair. But when you are putting it in hot water before, then you're focusing on every angle of the hair. So I hope you understand, guys. So right now I'm just going to coil this up, and as you can see, I'm combing it because I don't want any tangle. So always make sure the hair is tangled free as you do this. So after combing it, I'm just going to keep on rolling the hair. So just like you see, I'm rolling it flat onto the flexi rod. So after coiling it, as you can see, I just bent the rod, but I recommend you add like a pin or something to hold this down properly. I just realized it like afterwards, but believe me guys, it can coil up really beautifully even if you don't add any pin at all. So right now I'm going to go over with my Mega Growth Leave-In Conditioner and then a hair oil. Any hair oil of your choice is fine. So what I'm going to do is to add it onto the hot water, and then I'm going to stir. After stirring, I'm just going to put this hair, just the coily part, inside the hot water. So you always want to make sure the water is very hot, like extremely hot, as you do this, because you want the coils at least to pop and it should last longer. So one thing is the hair coiling and another thing is the hair lasting longer. So you want to achieve both. So always make sure at least the water is very hot and the hair is saturated inside the water. So after doing this, guys, all I'm going to do is to dry up the hair. So like, we were really in a haste, we were really fast about this because she really needed to go to work and we just had to film this. So because of that, guys, I just had to like remove this, but always make sure the hair is partially dried before you remove this. But before removing it, I actually cleaned it pretty well. I did like a thorough cleaning on this to make sure the whole water is not like much on the hair again. So after doing that, guys, this is what we have. The coils came out really beautiful. Like when I unraveled the coils, like I was really feeling the hair, and a lot of comments, compliments and everything going around this hair. So this is what the hair should be looking like after you're done with the whole unraveling of the coils and everything. So right now, just the tips of the hair, you're just going to like cut out any excess part you definitely don't need on the coils. And this is what we have, guys. So beautiful. So guys, because my battery was low and definitely I couldn't film again, but I made sure like I gave you some pictures of how the hair looks like. So as you can see, guys, the hair really came out so beautiful. So let me know, guys, if you are going to be trying this in the comment section, because I would definitely love to see your comments. Well, that's it about this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video.